But we do start with Michigan State, and the storylines abound, as you know, this year in this offseason in East Lansing, starting with all the departures, whether it was transfers, whether it was graduation, early entries or dismissal, a dozen players with eligibility remaining after 2016, not on this year's roster. Among those who are back, Brian Lewerke, taking over as the unquestioned leader under center, and running back LJ Scott. Still, overall, three starters, that's it, returning from last year's offense. Isn't much more experience on the other side of the ball, linebacker Chris Fry, leading four returning starters to a D which gave up at least 28 points on eight different occasions last season. MSU's 3-9 record in 2016, by far the worst of the Mark D'Antonio era. Only the second time in the past decade the Spartans failed to finish above 500. Good news, no one plays the underdog role better.
I think it starts with our seniors stepping up. And something we have been doing this offseason is trying to bring the team together as one. And I think we're doing a really good job at it, but you know, there's always more to do. There's always, you can always get better at what you're doing. So to get that chip back on our shoulder, which I don't think we've ever lost, but to get it to a higher level, it comes down to the team coming together and the younger guys stepping up into bigger roles too.
Chris Fry, among those that got in there.
Leadership. I feel like it's the main thing, you know, within the players. You know, Coach D been preaching a lot about being player-led, and I feel like that's like probably the biggest thing, you know, that's going to help us get back on track to where we was at.
We're just focusing on getting the taste out of, you know, last season out of the mouths, and we've just been, you know, working hard to regain, like you said, that chip on our shoulder and getting back to that attitude of, you know, playing winning football.